guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys so much for clicking on this video. I'm so excited about this video because I'm starting a special seasonal mini series where every single Thursday leading up to Christmas, we're going to wrap a gift and we're also going to chat about all different types of lifestyle related things like relationships, sex, breakups, insecurities, body image, all different types of topics. And we're going to get really in depth with my personal experiences with some of these things. And we're just gonna get really, really open over here and we're gonna talk and we're gonna wrap a gift. And I think it's gonna be really fun. So if you guys are excited for this idea, leave it a thumbs up because it helps my channel out so much when you guys do that. But today, I actually had something on my mind relating to my age and I thought we would talk about it. About how I've been feeling, and I feel like there were some things I was told before I turned 30 that I kind of wish I wasn't, because now that I'm here, I wasn't prepared for certain things. And if you're in your late 20s, I want you to be prepared for everything that you might feel and that you might experience once you get here, because I definitely didn't think anything was gonna change and it did. So we're gonna be talking about what those changes are, the physical, the mental, just everything in this video while I wrap a present. Now it was actually kind of interesting because I'm not gonna show you guys the gift that I'm wrapping. I'll show you guys that after. But I know there's gonna be some little stinker too in there somewhere. Like, I know most of you wouldn't do this, but there's gonna be someone that comments what it is that I'm wrapping. And I'm really trying to avoid that because it's a gift for Mark and he reads my comments and I don't want him to know what he's getting. So I'm not gonna show you guys. I don't have a box for this, so I'm gonna try and wrap it this way. And I do kind of have this idea for how I want all the presents under the tree to look this year. I'm really getting into it because, I mean, what else are we gonna do? 2020 has been nutsacks. So I'm wrapping it different. I don't actually have classic wrapping paper. I'm gonna be using this. And I thought that this was just, you know, plain white wrapping paper, but I've made some mistakes with my Amazon purchases in the past and apparently continue to keep making them, where I don't look at the reviews and I don't make sure that I know exactly what I'm buying. I just look at the image and the title and I'm like, that's what I need. So I thought this was white wrapping paper, but it's actually like that paper that you put on like easels. Is that the right word? Like the painting easels. You might have different wrapping paper next Thursday because I don't know how this is gonna go. And also, I'm aware that as I'm uploading this video, it is Thursday. It's very early to start with Christmas stuff. I understand. But I feel like this year has been tragic. It's been a year. It's definitely been the weirdest year that I've ever had in my life for numerous reasons. One of them, just the physical changes and the mental changes I wasn't expecting to start feeling once I hit 30. And was even feeling a little bit before that, but just wasn't like conceptualizing what I was feeling. But not only that, we have a global pandemic and, you know, this is gonna be a disaster. So I'm gonna just be rapping while I'm talking to you. And we're gonna see how this turns out, and hopefully it's not an absolute shit show. Does anybody else love the sound of like scissors when it glides through paper? It is so satisfying to me. So I did cut my bangs and I'm not sure how I feel about it. I feel like it looked better last year than it does this year. Can anybody explain that to me? Like, how did I look good with bangs last year, not this year? It's probably got something to do with perspective. I feel like we tend to look at ourselves through the lens of whatever it is that we're feeling. Like, if we're depressed or anxious, we're extra critical over ourselves. So I remember hearing so many people say this, like, when I was in my 20s, because once I got into my late 20s, I would bring up randomly throughout in conversation or whatever with people, like, that I was scared to turn 30, I was scared of getting old. And I would always hear people say that 30s were their best years, and like, you just wait, when you turn 30, you know, your life is gonna get even better. Like, people always talked it up, like it was a really nice age to be. And so I was just kind of expecting that when I hit 30, that I was going to feel the same way. I was gonna be like, I don't feel any different. I actually remember my 19th birthday. I was really anxious on that birthday because it was hard for me to leave my teen years behind, which I know is strange because I feel like I've talked to other teenagers where they're excited to leave the teen years behind. It's like once they get to their 20s, they feel like they're finally respected, which I totally get. But for me, like I dreaded turning 20. I don't know why. And so maybe there's something in me that just is naturally scared of going into new decades. I'm sure when I turn 40, I'm gonna really be freaking out, or maybe I'll have more things in my life to distract me from freaking out about it. I really don't know. But for some reason, going into a new decade, it freaks me out. So there's that whole mindset shift where it's like I can conceptualize, oh my God, like I'm 30. And then there's also the physical changes and things that I'm experiencing that I just wasn't expecting. Because I think when people say that, you know, your 30s are your best years, it's probably in other ways, but there's definitely a lot of things that I've noticed about myself that I never had to deal with before, with fears and anxieties, and then also the physical changes that have happened to my body as well. There's this weird separation between me and myself. It's like I've only been with me for like 30 years of my life. I should know myself by now, right? But I feel kind of disconnected from myself sometimes. And I think it's because I've spent such a huge portion of my life, like just living it and not really figuring myself out. So now that I'm 30, all of a sudden I'm like, wow, now it's really time to learn yourself and to take care of yourself. That's a big thing because I feel like my entire 20s, I did not take care of myself at all, like in any way, shape, or form. And I've always heard my entire life, like, oh, you look so young and blah, blah, blah. People still say it. I had someone actually, I should probably be doing this at the same time. I just feel like it's gonna be distracting now that I'm down here. But I had someone leave me a comment on my last video that said, oh my God, like I thought you were like 19. And I can see where that comes from because I definitely do have, like, I've always had like the cheeky baby face and stuff like that. And I know I don't act my age. And you know when you're around certain people and like their vibe is like you can tell that they're older and more mature. I just don't have that vibe. I wish that I did. I know that I will get there. I just guess I need a little bit more life experience than most 30-year-olds that I have been around. And also keep in mind, everything I'm talking about is through my personal experience, thoughts, and opinions. It's not meant to project onto you guys or to be you. If you are, you know, 30 or 38 or 35 or whatever age you are, like, this is just how I feel with it. It's not me saying you guys need to feel this way or everyone feels this way. This is just my own personal thing that I've been experiencing. And like I said, I wish someone had told me that, you know, you might kind of go through like a 30-year-old midlife crisis. I have felt so different in my own skin in like so many different ways. So I was prepared to hit 30 and still feel the same. And I wasn't prepared to hit 30 and have this instant panic and anxiety associated with basically anything. And I already struggle with anxiety anyways, so I think that this is probably because I'm already an anxious person. But I wasn't expecting that when I hit 30 that I was gonna have as much anxiety around my health and being alive and my parents' health and everyone around me that's older. I'm at this place where I am worried about something bad happening all the time. And I think it's because I didn't like fully process that I'm gonna get older one day and I'm gonna lose people one day. And one day I'm not gonna be here either. And I know that's very morbid to talk about, but I didn't really process that as a reality one day. And so I think that for some reason, when I got to my age, I started like realizing like, my parents' age and worrying about them all the time, especially with this COVID thing. And when I was younger, I definitely had like fears associated with my parents' age. My parents had me when they were a lot older than most of my friends' parents growing up. And I remember when I realized my parents were older than, you know, my friends' parents, I would worry about them all the time, like, is something bad gonna happen to them? Now that I'm 30, I have two things that I'm anxious about. One, I'm anxious about losing the people around me. And then two, I'm anxious about being an older parent. And this is personal choice, okay? This is a personal choice thing. This isn't a reflection of what I think anyone else should do or how I think anyone else should feel. This is just what I want for myself. It's not something that I think other people have to feel for themselves or whatever. Like, I think that people should live their lives the way that best suit them, and they shouldn't worry about what anyone else is doing or what anyone else says. And especially when it comes to something like, you know, starting a family and like having kids and things like that, like, I think that it should be a personal choice on when you do that and how you feel about that. But because of my parents being older when they had me and like the way that I felt about that when I was growing up, I didn't ever want my kids to feel like scared that they were gonna lose me or not have me as long as their friends were gonna have their parents. Like, I don't want them to think about things like that. So essentially, like, I don't wanna be an old mom. And when I hit 30, this is the first time I've ever done this. But I thought, I was like, if I all of a sudden popped out a baby right now, not tried right now, but if I popped out a baby right now, when my child is 10 years old, I'm gonna be 40. And I know that that's something that doesn't affect a lot of people, and it shouldn't. You do you. You do you with what you want, or you do what you want with your body. You have kids if you want kids. You don't have kids if you don't want kids. You know, you do your own thing. But for me personally, like, I never wanted to be an older mom. And for some reason, throughout my 20s, it's like I didn't process, oh yeah, I'm gonna actually hit 30. Like, it was just like I would put it off in my head, like, we'll set that aside and deal with it later. But the problem is I just kept putting it aside over and over and over again until here I am, I'm 30 and not prepared for anything in my life. I come from a area in the United States, the South, where it's very common to have your kids really young. And I'm glad I did not do that, by the way. Like, I'm so glad I didn't do that. I had one pregnancy scare with my ex, ironically, you know, around when we had broken up, and I was already moving on. And I remember just feeling like, what am I gonna do, like, if I'm actually pregnant right now? I never even told my ex about it because, like I said, like, we were going through a breakup, and I didn't really know what I was gonna do. And I had never been put in a position before where I had to, like, actually consider, like, alternatives or what would I do if I was pregnant right now, and, like, what would the odds be of me becoming pregnant, like, while I'm in the middle of a breakup with somebody I don't wanna be with. It was just a very, very strange time. But at that time, you know, I was 22, and the last thing that I could ever think about wanting at that point in my life was kids. Like, that was just something where I was like, no. And I don't know what I would have done if I had found out that I was pregnant at that time, because I was in a really, really weird place. You know, leaving a 5-year relationship where you're engaged to that person, like, is weird anyways, but then you're doing it in the middle of, like, oh my God, what if I'm, like, pregnant? Also really weird to think that if I was, I would have a 7-year-old. But, like, at that time, I was not ready for that at all. And really, that was only 8 years ago. So it's crazy how you can see how quickly your mind can change with things. Even like about 2 or so years ago is when I really, really started heavily thinking about kids and like wanting them. Like I knew I always wanted them, but it was around then when I was just like, I really want them really bad. But like, you know, we lived in a one bedroom apartment and it just wasn't a good time. And then you guys all know what happened when we moved into the house. Like that definitely wasn't a good time. And it just feels like, it always feels like it's never a good time. Like there's always something. And I've heard people say that, you know, there's never a perfect time, but I definitely think you should wait until your life is situated and makes a bit more sense than like, you know, I never would have had a kid in that house that flooded. Like that never would have happened. So even though like I wanted kids for the past couple of years and it was something that I was thinking more about, like I really, really intensely started having like, the only way I can describe it is baby fever, but it hit me hard after I turned 30. Like, oh man, like really hard. And so I'm at this place where I'm constantly just like daydreaming and like imagining like when I get to be a mom, and like I know that there's gonna be like hard times and I know it's gonna be like tiring, but I'm so excited for like all of that. And like I said prior, when I had that pregnancy scare, like I couldn't have thought about the good and the bad and been happy about any of it. Like I wasn't happy in my place in my life. I didn't know where I was gonna be. And it just was not something that I could process. But now it's like, I think about it and it makes me like, it's something that I'm very, very, very ready for. We're in a really good environment now. The only thing is the coronavirus and Mark doesn't have a job. So there's those hiccups, but besides that, it's like I'm ready and I get so excited to think about it. And I don't know why for me when I hit 30, it just kind of like became like, okay, like it's about that time. I think really what it is a mental thing. I think that, like, I don't think there was something in my body that was like released when I hit 30 that made me be like, okay, now's the time. But I think because I'm able to conceptualize time and age and how quickly these 30 years I've already lived have gone by and how life doesn't stop for anybody. It just keeps going and going and going. There's never perfect times for anything. And like just thinking about like how quickly everything is passing me by. And here I am, like just me, myself, and I, and I'm just so ready for, I'm ready to live my life more selflessly. I've had 30 years of living it selfishly and for me, myself, and I, and I'm at this place where I'm ready to not do that anymore. And it's something that for me personally, I will feel so fulfilled once I finally get to have that. And it's just like, I've been thinking about it so much. It's unreal. And I've been kind of living through other people. Like I like to watch other people that have like, you know, their babies and their videos and stuff. It's so cute. And I just like to think about like, would I ever put my kid on the internet or would I not? I don't think that I would. It's such an interesting time in my life, like where there's all this new that I'm thinking about and I just feel completely different. It's so weird. And it's why I wanted to do this video, because comparing me in my 20s to me at 30 is like a completely different person. And yes, I just hit 30 in August, so obviously I was the same in, you know, my late 20s, but things are just so different. But I think I've just been struggling a lot with processing how fast my 20s went by, and that's probably how fast my 30s are gonna go by. And I don't wanna let it just pass me by like my 20s did, where I'm always waiting on tomorrow for this or waiting on tomorrow for that, or I'm not improving myself or improving my life and letting myself just be like this all the time. I want to be changing and evolving into a more positive direction in my life and into better places. Apart from that, I think that a lot of my fears with waiting too long to like start a family and stuff like that is like I started noticing just changes in my body that I never noticed before, and like realizing how many things are different, like waking up with a sore back every single morning, which I know could be contributed to your mattress, but I literally got a new mattress like a year and a half ago or something like that. It's so weird to me how your body just starts to kind of fall apart. I can't eat dairy without dairy pills, and I still think eating dairy with dairy pills is breaking me out. And it makes me so incredibly sick. And that used to be something that was like no problem. Like I could always eat dairy. And the only thing that I can think of is that I'm getting older and my body is changing. And also another thing was I didn't take care of myself physically and mentally throughout my 20s. So now I'm left with this mess of a person that hasn't been working on themselves for the past 10 years. And if you guys, you know, watched my last videos where I was talking about how I've felt about, you know, my body and my face and just everything, I've realized as I've been making changes and I've been getting regular exercise and I've been trying to eat on a routine that I haven't been doing these normal adult things that everyone has been doing for like 12 years, like at all. And I'm just now having to learn how to do this stuff. I feel like a shit 30-year-old. Like I feel like, I don't know if it was because I was the youngest growing up or what it is, but I just feel like I've lived my life spoiled and not grown up. And now that I'm this age that I am, I'm like, damn. Like, I don't ever want to lose my goofy sense of humor and my personality. I don't ever want those things to change. But what I do really want to change is the fact that I just have been living my life like I'm invincible and gonna live forever on, you know, corn dogs and chicken nuggets and soda pop, and I don't even say soda pop, why did I just say that? But like soda and like not exercising ever. Like, no, like I've already started getting the gray hair. I've already started getting the wrinkles. I've already started going through the body changes. My periods are different. And when you Google anything having to do with your period being weird or anything with that part of your body, like if you're a girl, you know, you either see you're pregnant, you have cancer, or you're going through premenopause, or you're dying, basically. Like there's no in between. You just see just these things constantly. And it's so freaking frustrating. Like, so the internet has made me like hella paranoid that I'm going through premenopause. I hope to God is not the case. Having kids is something that I really desperately want, and I hope that I don't have to struggle with that, but I know that, you know, I'm getting to the ages where this is where it starts getting more difficult for people. Like I've read that it can take 6 months to a year. I know that my mom always got pregnant really fast, so maybe it won't. And my mom did have me when she was in her late 30s. So I do have that to look forward to, that, you know, genetically you kind of follow in the footsteps of your mom. But my brain does this thing to me where it's like, well, you don't have anyone around you that's ever had trouble getting pregnant, or anyone around you that's ever had a bad pregnancy, so it's probably gonna be you. Like the odds are looking like, girl, you're the one that's gonna be the problem, because everybody else popped them out just fine. Oh my gosh, I don't know why my brain is so mean to me. I really couldn't tell you. But for whatever reason, this is the brain I was given, and she's cruel. But yeah, I don't know, I'm excited for these parts of life. These parts of life that I used to dread, like, I don't feel that way anymore. Something weird is going on with me. Some weird thing, and I'm sure you guys can tell, like, it's like a midlife crisis I'm going through where I'm just like, I need to get healthy. I need to fix every single thing all at the same time because life isn't stopping. I don't want you guys to think that I just sit around and I'm just always thinking about this one thing and anxious about this one thing and that I'm not, you know, living my life, because I definitely am. It's just something that I wasn't expecting because everyone talked about how great it was, and obviously I have newly arrived to these ages, and I'm sure that I'm going to learn so much throughout my journey of my 30s, and I'm sure there's going to be so many different life changes, the good, the bad, the ugly, and I'm gonna, you know, welcome it all with open arms. It's just so weird. I guess I just wish people told me your hair will start turning gray in your late 20s and your biological clock will be like ticking in your ear and you'll just be thinking about all the things you could have done, should have done, but didn't do and can't go back and do, so you gotta do it all now. Now, if you are someone that is in your 20s, I completely encourage you to live up those years, live them up, but also take care of yourself throughout them. Don't wait until you hit your 30s to start realizing that you need to take care of yourself so you can live a long, healthy life. Like, do it now. And I don't know who needs to hear this, but if you're someone that skips meals, I heard a nutritionalist say, or nutritionist, oh my God, can I even speak? But I heard them say that skipping a meal, you might as well have just had a pizza. So if you guys spent your entire 20s skipping most of your meals and being like insanely hungry at night, stop skipping your meals. You're not doing anything for your mind, body, and soul by doing that. So I don't know what I talked about this entire time. I don't even know if I made any sense, but I did manage to get the gift wrapped. Look at it. Is that not cute? Is that not freaking cute? Oh my gosh, our first gift under our tree. I guess I talked about everything I wanted to talk about in this video. I just hope it made any sense. It's just kind of where my frame of mind is at right now. I'm working on getting myself to a healthier place, and I'm not talking about just aesthetic wise, like I'm talking about mentally. I have been so cruel to myself in my mind and sometimes even out loud for far too long in my life, probably my entire life. And I need to start speaking positively over myself. And I have been doing really good with getting myself into a better routine. I've started paying attention to the type of things that I need. Like, I learned that I need more fats and protein. And so I'm trying to get all of those things in with the types of foods that I like to eat and just trying to get in some sort of exercise multiple times a week. Because, you know, I'm at that age where I need to take care of myself. Like, I don't want to be like all hunched over and like, ooh, my back's broken. You know what I mean? Like, by the time I'm 40, by the looks of it. I just want to be healthier. And one day when I get to be a mom, one day I will be a healthier mother. And I will be able to run around with my child and chase them down and try and get them to stop, I don't know, whatever it is that they're doing that they shouldn't be, because if they're gonna be my kid, I know what to look forward to. I hope this video made any kind of sense. Did it? I guess I'll find out in editing, and if not, I'm so sorry. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'll see you guys next Thursday for another wrap and chat, but like, stop. Like, this is cute. Like, it's not cute on the back, but the front is the cutest little toot I ever did see. I think this paper is pretty good. It just got wrinkled, but you know what? Chicken butt, and that's all I gotta say about that. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, because when you guys do that, it helps my channel out so much, and I always greatly, greatly appreciate it. I'm able to do this and to sit down and chat and film and hang out with you guys because of you guys. So thank you guys so much for that. And also, if you're in your 30s, what has it been like for you? Have you gone through any of the things that I described in this video, or is all of it just sound foreign to you? And if you just so happen to still be here, I would love it if you would leave me a little heart down below, whatever color heart you guys prefer, whichever one's your favorite. Leave me a heart emoji down below, because it lets me know who watched my videos from beginning to end. But thank you guys so much for being here. Happy Thanksgiving, and I will see you guys in my next video.